thank everybody for coming out. Sad that we have to have this reunion, such a sad occasion. But it's good to see the love between everybody. First, I want to introduce Bishop.
Bishop Ahmed M. Scriven.
Bishop Scriven, who's going to do the prayer of comfort. I'm hoping these are some powerful words because this is a man that meant so much to everybody. So he said that these words are supposed to find us comfort. Hopefully it does. Everybody, please remain standing for Bishop
Scriven.
Let us bow our heads for prayer. We look to thee, O God, for your comfort and your blessings upon this family. During this time, we know that you are here because your presence is everywhere. We come on today to celebrate the life of one who dedicated himself to the principles of discipline and of honor. And on today, we've come collectively to honor his memory. We pray right now for the comfort of his family, the comfort of all of those that have come under his leadership. We pray for the martial arts world that has been affected by the loss of such a great leader. And right now, we invoke your presence in this place. We pray on today that the words that are spoken in this place are words that will bring edification, bring comfort, bring joy, and bring peace to all that knew the Grandmaster. Now, dear God, we thank you, we glorify your name, and we lift you up, and let everyone say amen.
Amen.
Please remain standing. We're going to have our Old Testament reading by Minister Bridget, and our New Testament reading by Minister Tracy, in that order.
Good morning and God bless. I'll be reading in your hearings Psalms 90, verses 1 through 10. And it reads, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou hast turned man to destruction and saith, return ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are but a yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night, thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as asleep. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourishes and groweth up, and in the evening it is cut down and withereth. For we are consumed by thy anger, and by thy wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins as in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 70 years and 10, and if reason of strength, they be 80 years, yet is their strength, labor, and sorrow, for it is soon cut down, and we fly away. May God add a blessing to his already blessed word. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. A reading from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 1 through 5. For we know that our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved. We have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan earnestly, desiring to be clothed upon with our house, which is from heaven. If so be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, Not for that we would be unclothed, but be clothed. That morality might be swallowed upon life. Now he that has wrought us for his self-made thing is God, who also has given unto us the earnest of the Spirit. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated at this time. We're here today to memorialize one who has touched the lives of literally thousands of people through his martial arts ability and training, and that is none other than the Grandmaster, Fredrick Barron Godfrey Taylor. Could you put your hands together? To all of the grandmasters, to all of the masters, to all of the senseis, to all of the students, we greet you in the name of the eternal Us. At this time, we're going to have comments or reflections. I know that there are some here that would love to have something to say, but we're asking that you would limit your words to at least 2 minutes. If there's any resolutions or any types of condolence that's going to be offered, this is the time to please come at this time.
I would like all the ninjas to stand up. I would like all the turtles to stand up. I would like all the ninja turtles to stand up. Thank you. Just for a brief moment, for those of you who may not be aware of the history of Grandmaster Fredrick Barron Godfrey Taylor and myself, it was the early 1970s when I met this gentleman. Actually, it was in the 1960s when I met him at Morton Street School. He taught children. He taught kids. Anybody that knows me knows that I love kids. You have to love someone who wants to nurture kids. You have to take the time to understand the psyche of someone who wants to provide a sense of direction to kids. At a demonstration, he asked me if I would join his organization. Now, my organization was Turtle Tactics. It's something that I started at the college that I was attending in Boston, Massachusetts, back in the early 60s. It was the first such organization of its kind. Martial arts, no one knew what martial arts was. But when we got together, we brought a crowd into a little hole in the wall at 849 South Orange Avenue. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. To bring Master Floyd, can you say? We were going to what?
Rule the world.
We had no clue. We had no systemic, no system on how to do that, but we were going to rule the world. The organization grew and continued to grow. Preston Carter from Trenton translated. He asked me to take over that organization. They joined us. The organization grew to such an extent that when we walked into tournaments and things of that nature, you knew that the Ninja Turtles were there. You knew that you were in for an excellent process to your process. From a very fundamental level, Grandmaster Godfrey being ninja, karate, myself being turtle tactics, I came up with this moniker called Ninja Turtle. And we had a peer accreditation for Grandmaster Godfrey at that time. And we became known as the Ninja Turtles. A lot of people laughed at that name. But what became history, not a cartoon, but the reality of the social dynamic of turtles coming out of a sewer, or how about inner city kids coming out of the inner city? We know where the ideology came from. We know that we had information to pass on to youth. In the karate school, in the dojo, there were two books that I utilized relative to their philosophical and spiritual training. One was the Quran, the other was the Bible. Religion tends to separate us, but righteousness integrates us. Those individuals that were part of that organization, not only in Southland Avenue, but down neck, Sensei Kinsler, Sensei Floyd, we became a family, regardless of what our religious offerings and desires were. They're still together today, loving and caring about one another, regardless of what the religious faith is. The world is full of religious people, but not full of righteous people. There's only one road to God, and that is righteousness. Those that fear God and work righteousness are accepted with Him. I didn't write that, but I quote that because it's so apropos. This man, we haven't lost him, because if you take the I out of Marshall and kind of twist it, it becomes marital. A marriage came out of Master Godfrey, myself, and all of you young ladies and gentlemen, and your students, and their students, and their students. It's a perpetuation of something that was handed down from on high. When you listen to the voice, I don't care which book you read, it talks about the voice of God. Would you repeat after me? Words are power. Words are power. When you begin to change your words, your power increases. Think about what I'm saying. Words are power. I go into prisons often. I go into jails often, and I ask the inmates, what keeps you here? They'll tell me the system keeps me here. My stupidity keeps me here. And I said, no. When you stand before the judge has either memorized something, some statute, or some ordinance that you broke, or they'll read it from a book. Words keep you incarcerated. Words can also free you. This man freed a number of youth. You're sitting here today.
May I say one more thing?
Thank you.
Would you stand up, Sister Perry? This young lady was the first female student at our school, the very first. She'd come across the street every night, put her nose against the window, trying to see through the sweat. And her eyes were as big as saucers. They still are, and they're beautiful. I walked outside and I said, do you want to learn karate? She said, her eyes lit up. Here she is, Master Karen.
Ladies and gentlemen, Grandmaster Bill Wilson.
Brothers, assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah. I didn't come for this.
I came for the enjoyment of seeing those who followed behind Grandmaster Godfrey. And we have such a list that it takes me back into knowing this gentleman when he was living with us. He's still living with us in our hearts. He'll always be in my heart. I met him when he was 12. My wife and his mother worked together in a hospital as nurses. I met him when he was 12. He came to the house. He wanted to show me some movements, and he had an idea, nice ideas. I corrected a few ideas, and I got him on another road. But he had that road that he talked about, such as the gentleman who just got off of the mic. I've been knowing him for many, 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 many years, and I enjoyed everything he did. And I don't think there's any better place than the city of Newark, because everywhere I go, and I've traveled quite often, I've been all overseas, I've been from every place you can name over there in the Far East. Also, I studied in Osaka, Japan in 1951, 52, 53, 54, and I was in the Korean War then. But I also find that when I came home, we had ingenuity of every person that came towards, they were all talking about this martial art. In Japan, it was the way of life. It wasn't talked about much. You either did it or you didn't do it. But with this gentleman coming from those sitting that I'm sitting with in the rear of me, I watched them through the years, the greatness of them. Each and every one of them did great things and great moments, but to the person that's doing it, he doesn't think of greatness, he think about something on his mind. And I was listening to everybody's thoughts, traveling along with my own, which is Goshishan Karate. I found out that everything sitting in that row behind me as I speak is 100%, because I watched them grow, I watched them teach to grow others to where they at, and I watched the great and supremacy of Newark, New Jersey. I was born in Newark, born on Broome Street, raised up on Somerset and Spruce. I'm from the Central Ward of Newark, old Newark. And I've watched the, every place we go, they call us the Mecca. I don't care if we go out west, I've been out west. I don't care if we went to the Cowboy States, I've been there. And out east, alhamdulillah, we all from the east. But the idea is the sun rise in the east and set in the west. We rose up from the Far East, and we're setting in the West. And in this Western of the United States, I think that the credit goes to Jersey, not because I'm from Jersey, that's part of it though. It's the reason that I watched the fellas that's sitting behind me grow, and I can name each and every one of them by name. Especially this gentleman, please. Yes, you, sir. This gentleman here, I watched for many, many years. I lived up the street from him, in fact. And in fact, I'm talking about Taheed at the moment.
Indeed.
Another one of the greats who left up out of Newark. I had Taheed. I had James Fain.
Indeed.
It was all of my top black belts now.
Indeed.
But I was watching you. Yeah. This gentleman here, I watched through the years, and I, as I say, I was 17 years old when I went to service. When I got out, I was in my early 20s. The life was just starting to kick. I'm 81 now, but the idea is being 81. I watch guys grow behind me. I watch guys stand up and look strong. We are the Mecca. I want to say that because this gentleman I speak about, who has, he didn't leave us, he's in our heart, but he has left us at a distance. Grandmaster Garfield was a friend of mine, not just a student, but a friend. And I used to watch him every single day, his bicycle tricks, his chair tricks, everything about him. But I watched where he was the night before he came to see me. And the day after seeing me, where did he go? And he went from place to place to place. He was a searcher. He found everything within himself, but he needed to let it out. So he started opening up schools, which was a good thing. And at that time, we were talking about the early 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s. I've seen them all. This man has never let us down. When I came home from teaching the class at my dojo in East Orange, I talked to his wife on the phone because she had called the house. And I was not surprised because this could happen to any one of us. When it's time to leave, we will leave. And we'll leave quietly. You might put up a little fight, but you can't win this one. But the idea is he didn't put up a fight. He knew in his mind that one day he would have such leaders as, can you stand for a minute, sir? This gentleman here that I've been watching all through the years, I remember him when he was a kid. I remember him when he was a gentleman, then he was a sensei, then he became Grandmaster. I watched him grow. Everything behind me. There's another gentleman I would like to bring up. Stand up, please. This man here, this is a gentleman and a half. For those who know him and those who don't, you don't know everything until you met him. He came up with another very good friend of mine, Jim Cheatham. Chi-Chi was my best friend. He followed me from 7th Avenue to 470 Broad Street to 210 Market Street, right on up the ladder, and I watched him. We were together every single day. People didn't know that. He wasn't my enemy, different schools, but that happens. But he was my friend. Grandmaster Godfrey, Jim Cheatham knew that Godfrey was going to be a student of mine. He knew it, because Godfrey hung around some of the greatest. But when he made such leaders as the one who's leading their organization now, there's no finer. I watched him grow too. I've been watching with a sneaky eye on everything around me. I can't trust none of them either. But the, but the idea is they're from the Mecca. And I want everybody to know we are the Mecca. Newark, New Jersey is the Mecca.
Some of you know him as G-Man. We know him now as Shion Jamal Pearson.
On behalf, on behalf of my instructor, Grandmaster Kevin Thompson, and the Shaquille School of Martial Arts, we have a presentation to make to Grandmaster Eugene Floyd. Can you come forth, sir? And I will give the microphone to Professor Ibrahim, because he came up in the era, so it's more apropos for Professor to talk about the Grandmaster.
Thank you, Judy. Before I read this, let me first thank the Almighty Creator of the heavens and the earth. Because without the Creator, regardless of what you call him, none of us would be here. He created the heavens, the seven angels, the laws of gravitation, the forces of nature. Two-thirds of the earth is water. Only 25% is land. He keeps everything in order for you and me to be here. So I say in the name of God, most gracious and most merciful, the all-wise, the all-knowing. We thank him for all of us being here today. We also thank him, and we never forget those who have paved the road before us, our ancestors, who many of us have forgotten. Nat Turner, Harriet Tubman, Sojourner Truth, Paul Robeson, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Dr. Martin Luther King, Coretta Scott King. I can go on and on. We're standing on their shoulders. Imam Wahdatuddin Muhammad. All of the great people that we know, that many of them, who I can't name all of them at this point, I always give greetings to them, even in my prayers. Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi, Yitzhak Rabin of Israel, the Prime Minister of Israel, all of the good people who were standing for humanity. And before I say anything, Master Floyd, Master Bowes, Lisa, Troy, Ed, my partner Bernard and I at the East Orange School of Martial Arts. You look so good, I forgot who you are. Pleasure to see you, my brother. Now let me ask everyone to stand for our brother, Asatita Shaquille, better known as the eighth wonder of the world. Oosh! He's asked me to do this, and it's an honor and a pleasure for me to stand here before you today. The speaker said we have 2 minutes. Well, I think we got...
Go.
Let me read from his heart. A brother who I love so much with my heart.
Right.
From my soul to my heart to my mind. Why? Because not only is he a great practitioner like all of you all, and Master Godfrey, Master Fred Godfrey, but they were great practitioners for humanity.
Indeed.
The way they treated people.
Indeed.
The way they talked to people. They didn't make people their slaves as their teachers. They had open arms. Grandmaster Kevin Thompson. Shaquille School of Martial Arts, Karate Organization, Inc. Lifetime Achievement Award.
Yes, sir.
Grandmaster Fredrick Godfrey. He was one of the premier martial arts instructors in Newark, New Jersey during the late 60s and early 70s. He was a multifaceted practitioner, and he was indeed, who studied many of the arts such as karate, aikido, jiu-jitsu, ninjutsu, weaponry, and many of the other arts which he became very proficient at. He taught in many of the local recreation centers, churches, boys' clubs, parks, anywhere that people of the community wanted to learn. Many of these classes were taught from the pure goodness of his heart and soul. He did not charge mankind, but what he charged was strict discipline, hard work, courtesy, and respect. For one who stood out among all of the rest was Grandmaster Eugene Moore, who became Grandmaster and a world champion. Grandmaster Eugene Floyd took his instructor's system all over the world, demonstrating, competing, and giving seminars to honor his great teacher. Since then, Grandmaster Floyd has taught thousands of students the system that was handed down to him from his great teacher. Those students have become national and world champions. We at the Shaquille School of Martial Arts, Karate Organization, Inc., salute Grandmaster Godfrey and his family for dedicating most of their entire lives to helping others. Grandmaster Kevin Thompson, along with the Shaquille School of Martial Arts, would like to say to you, are the lifetime achiever. May God bless you for touching so many lives around the world. I told him, God just used him as a vehicle. I said, Shaquille, this is not you. God is just talking through you. Asatita, did I miss anything? I love you, Asatita. Love you, Fred Godfrey.
Right.
Wise man said once, there's no such thing as a physical death. We only make a transition. Prophet Esau, even Yusuf, Jesus said, those who believe in me will live forever. Those who believe in God, as Master Bo said, he will live forever. Look at you. So he's not dead. He only made a transition. Now lastly, in the spirit of those who taught me, the Honorable James Cheatham, the Honorable Ronald Duncan, who all of you know was the father of
jiu-jitsu,
not only in Japan, but in America.
America.
The Honorable Moses Powell, I bring you greetings in my spirit that emanates in me, all of them. May God bless us all and have mercy on us all. Master Floyd and his wife. Master Godfrey's wife. And let's give praise and thanks to God for her. Master Godfrey's wife.
Let me just start off by saying all praises due to God. I want to just bring not only greetings, but also to every grandmaster that is here, to every master, to every shihan, to every sensei, instructor, to all the family, to Karen, and all that are present here this afternoon. I am not only honored to be here to stand among so many of you, but the honor for y'all to say that gave me an opportunity to be who I am and strictly who martial arts. And when we talk about Grandmaster Godfrey, very quick joke, I remember one day on Maple Avenue when he first came to the store on Maple, and he had his bed nails. And I thought it was easy. So he looked at me and I said, Grandmaster Godfrey, I want to lay on those nails. So I kept seeing him do these nails and breaking bricks, him and other black belts. I laid on those nails, and that was the last time I ever laid on a bed of nails. And I thought I could break that. Red brick used to break it. One chop. I went to try that. He said, go ahead. I went to chop that brick, and to this day, I think my hand is still hurting from trying to display the things that he did. But again, on behalf of Grandmaster Brick, my father, Grandmaster Brick, because he couldn't be here today, my father's out of town, Brick is out of town, and the entire Green School of Martial Arts, we not only bring our condolences, we are to be a family. I look out and see all my brothers and sisters who I came through martial arts with, and I look at Grandmaster Floyd over there, who, like I say, his heart is 100%. He always talked about Grandmaster Godfrey. We got on the phone a couple of times, but to Karen, haven't seen you in a while. You know what? God is good, because in a way, sometimes opportunities like this bring all of us together when we don't get a chance to see each other as much. So again, we just wanted to make sure that our presence was felt. We do have a couple of students here, Charles Michaels and Shane came up today. So again, to all my brothers and sisters in the martial arts, we give our condolences. May God allow Godfrey to rest in peace, and may all the things he had displayed by God kept him on this earth, that we remember him and continue to live his legacy in the martial arts.
I'd like to introduce right now the Reverend Dr. Ronald Christian. Please be seated. There's no way this many black belts can stand up for a purple belt.
Give honor to God, who is both the author and finisher of my faith. We were in Haiti on a missions trip. But when I think about the tremendous contributions that this man has added to my life, there was no mountain high, no valley low, no river wide enough to keep me from getting here today. I just want to make brief comments because I am around, like, there's some dangerous people in this room, man. I mean, I feel so safe right now in Irvington, word is bond. I feel like can't nothing happen to me. Well, y'all Negroes can kill the Taliban. I mean, y'all like, praise the Lord, assalamu alaikum to the Muslim. I mean, I feel tremendously blessed, like a homegoing. This blessed me more than it even can bless anyone here. A week before Sensei Boss passed away, he was walking down Nesbitt Terrace and I saw him, and he was asking me, he said, would I mind sponsoring some children for $5 a piece so that he could teach them inside of this place that he was renting. I told him, Sensei, you can come here, you can use our church for free. Grandmaster, I didn't hear from Sensei Boss. And please excuse, I don't know the grandmasters and the titles. When I came up with
Say it.
Eugene and Floyd, no disrespect, amen. I was Ronald, amen. So we only had one teacher. We had one sensei, and he was second or third degree black belt at the time we started. I'll get into that. A week after seeing Sensei Boss, I found out like a month later that he had passed. And he had passed and he was funeralized down in Perry's, I believe. And it really grieved my spirit and my soul, because I thought about a man that added so much to so many and didn't get any final recognition or homegoing celebration. It broke my heart to think that we didn't get a chance to recognize a man that has given his heart, soul, and tears to young lives. And that's what gave me joy when I saw your students celebrate you at Bella Italia, giving you your flowers while you're here to smell them, and recognizing you and adoring you and loving on you and just thanking God for you and all that you've done in their lives. So I just thank God that we still have that type of community that doesn't want to miss that opportunity. And I just want to say this. I just have two things to say. I wanted to say that when we started in the parking lot of Clearview Baptist Church, I don't know what he is now, but that was Peanut. I don't know. Hey, that was Peanut. Huh? Who? Grandmaster Peanut. Hey, man, please, Lord, don't let nobody hurt me today. I ain't trying to be disrespectful words, but I've got to preach tomorrow. Hey, man, I mean, we were running. I mean, everything Sensei Godfrey taught us, we believed it. We'd have to walk around with no shoes on. He told us to run into trees. Amen. Run, take your shirt off, and run into a tree. Say, how long? He said, until the tree fall down. Amen. I want to say I fell before the tree fell, but it taught me something. It instilled something. Learning katas and breathing correctly and discipline, love for others and self-discipline. Not only is it dangerous, men in this room, I want to say this, and this is touching something, that karate for us was not just a defense, but it was taught as a lifestyle. It wasn't something that we put on when we went in the dojo and went home and disrespected our parents or disrespected our community, because you'd have to deal with that when you got back to the dojo. Amen, somebody. You have to deal with that. Amen. And I look at this, and this is where I come to my close, and I look at this and I say, you know, a lot of us are here today. Our fathers were not present. Either they were absent. No one's dealing with that. Either our fathers were absent, or our fathers were working and never home, or our fathers were not there for whatever reasons. And these senseis, the ones that are here today, and the ones that raised us, you were the people that stepped in and are stepping in as our fathers. That's where we got it from. I mean, really, I mean, we had no options. We left Monday, Wednesday, Friday, father at home or father not home, father working. We went to a church to study karate, to learn discipline, to bow down and honor the principles of martial arts, not to let your belt hit the floor. That's 100 push-ups. Back then, I don't know about now, amen. I don't do kung fu, I do gun fu. But back then, when you got a belt, you earned that belt. Nobody gave you no belts. I don't care how much you paid or didn't pay. When you went from white to a yellow or to a purple, you best believe you knew every technique involved with the earning of that belt. And if you didn't know it or you forgot it, you would be stripped down of it. And I just want to say, you know, there were a lot of, you know, I mean, I remember the Bruce Marshalls and the Turtle System and, you know, Boss, the Blalian System, amen. I just, you know, amen. You know, I was so shot out over Sensei Godfrey, and I thank God that it didn't happen. I used to pray that my eyes would separate, like, so I'd be able to see, you know, like, you know how he used to be looking, you know, he like, he'd be talking to you, but he looking all around him, he'd be like, you know. I was like, what style is that? I want that style with my eyes. You know, you emulate. He was a man that I personally emulated. And it is through his instruction, it's him honestly being there during the absence of my father that I learned manhood, and I learned pride, and I learned self-determination. He was a role model, as you senseis are now, not just doing this for money, because Councilman Green has more money than anybody in the place, but he still teaches, amen. But, politician coming out now. No, I don't. So I'm just saying that a lot of you give blood, sweat, and tears, and you increase people's talent and you increase their abilities, not for a dollar, because you remember that someone taught and trained you when there was no man present in our homes, in our life. And I close by this, by saying Sensei Godfrey, when he was living, maybe he was living on Elizabeth Avenue up in, Oh God. I remember somebody tried, funny story, somebody tried to rob him. When he had a bicycle, but he got a bicycle technique. He used the bike, he beat the dude up with the bike, with the bicycle, like, who uses a bicycle as boom chucks? That's another story, but. I was using combs and hitting myself in the head. I mean, I close with this. I'm honored to be here. And I got on the plane, I shot back because I didn't want to miss this. But I want to say that he taught us boys to practice and stop looking for a leader and become a leader. Stop looking for a change and become a change. And stop looking for the man and become a man. And we are here today. And we are here today from the benefit of all that he has taught us, all he has dreamt for us, and all he has inspired us to do. And I close with this. I thank God again for Bruce Marshall. I thank God for the Shaquille Warriors. I thank God for the Turtle System. I thank God on it. I thank God for all the systems that are represented present in this house, because it was through Sensei Godfrey that taught us to beat all your love.
Ladies and gentlemen, a quick fix. Shion may have said that Grandmaster Brick wasn't here. He did make his way. And since we're recognizing local heroes and, you know, the local talent, we definitely have to recognize Jesse Smoke Harris.
Come on. Yeah, I can push it.
in his own right, he's famous. When I was younger, he was known as the Raven. But he's here today representing his mom, who has passed on, Master Diane Simpson. I want to introduce Master Andre. Go. All right, so the next person we're going to introduce is the mean one. She hits me with elbows and always wants me to be her hoopy when she does self-defense. As you all know, the Floyd family and the Godfrey family are one family. And she's here to memorialize her grandfather. Master Juan, tell us.
There is no Juan Ali, Peanut, and Tim Kinsler. There is no made so many. Mustafa Akbar, Devin Lewis, all the fruit from this one tree. And they may not be the direct lineage of this one person, but it's because of him. Online, we see a lot of people argue about the titles of Greek Grandmaster and Grandmaster and if it really, and what it signifies. The Greek Grandmaster doesn't signify that we want to elevate anybody any higher than what martial arts wants them to go. But if you have one grandparent, the person that came before them was great. And that's why we signify him as the Greek Grandmaster. Because he became a grandparent to all of us that came after us. The ones that came before us knew him as a mean person. The one that had you guys running in trees, training outside in the snow. But like a true grandparent, he softened up when his kids had kids. So when his kids had you guys training in the snow and running and doing 100 push-ups, he pulled you guys to the side and told you that it would be okay. Don't give up. It'll be all right. Today, the challenge that we have for you guys is that you pick up where he left off. Grandmaster Floyd, Grandmaster Kinsler, you guys have to now pick up the reins. But now it's up to Master Andre, Master Tyson, Master Double Double to pick up where they left off. We are losing a lot of kids in the streets because we don't have the Fred Godfrey anymore. Martial arts has turned into such a business that they'd rather lose kids and wear rest in peace t-shirts than help them. Because of the Grandmaster Godfrey, because of the Kareem Abdullah, because of all those guys, you've heard Kevin Thompson say to himself, he went from being a bad kid running around North, knocking people upside the head, being the eighth one in the world.
Yes, sir.
Right?
We can all us.
Us. Us. Us. Us.
It's said all the time when somebody passes away, it's such a cliche, don't be sad. Don't cry, he's in a better place. You won't hear that much. You're supposed to cry because you care about the person. But I want you to honor the person by doing what they started. Honor Grandmaster Godfrey by being the best person you can be.
Teach.
Honor Grandmaster Godfrey by picking up where you left off. Today, we saw the Lifetime Achievement Award from Shaquille School of Martial Arts to Grandmaster Godfrey. Today, we saw the person known as G-Man, then, Gian Jamal. Embrace and Gene Floyd, something we never thought we would ever see. At the Night of Legends, we saw Eugene Floyd in a Shaquille Warriors t-shirt. Again, something we never thought we would see. New Jersey scene kept been built on controversy. One of the greatest events that ever happened in Worlds Collide. Mid Green and Shane, they promoted it. And what we saw was the fight of the century. The two people that martial arts has always wanted to see go at it. And what we actually got from it was a brotherhood. Because they created history. And at Worlds Collide, on that day, 10 years ago, probably 11, you knew where you were at that moment. Because of that, you knew where you were. Because of that, today, they can embrace each other. 16 years. I can't say 16, then that makes me older than I really am. Because of that, you knew where you were. Because of the little martial arts here in New Jersey that many people don't really respect, you now have a principal, a father, someone that we can look up to. A person championing something that we knew nothing about and we were very ignorant toward, which was ALS. We thought it only affected Paul Heath. Here we see that it affected the brother of ours. Because of martial arts, we were able to be there when Mama Floyd passed away. And we saw the first person that walked through the door was none other than Master Peter.
Bush.
Because of martial arts, we're able to come together. We may not always like each other. But when the call went out, you gentlemen answered. Again, we know that you guys have things to do. Your personal business, your personal life, and you put that on hold to be here today. And that shows how great of a person that this man was. Because you all put your lives on hold for these couple of hours. You could have made an excuse, you could have made a reason why you couldn't be here. But you put things to the side and you were here, and we appreciate it. I want to acknowledge this boy, because at the meeting I said it and I'll say it again. You never meet a stronger person. Right now, on top of dealing with this, he's also dealing with what's going on with her dad. You'll never know it because he kept putting her phone number out there telling you guys to call her. And even while you guys were calling her, you didn't know that she was going through other things. She was in the hospital dealing with her dad, and you're calling her and she's giving you information on this. The backbone of Grandmaster Floyd. So I want to give her as much credit as you guys give to Master Karen, because you set the way. And you showed her, and hopefully all the other females in martial arts, what it's like to have somebody's back, what it's like to have your actual back for them. We all know that everyone has a Grandmaster Godfrey story. I believe you printed off an article by him beating somebody with bicycles.
So, we had an opportunity the other night to say our goodbyes to Grand. And I would like to give that thank you to Master Karen. And Grand was unique. Grand was born in the wrong century.
Teach.
Grand was definitely born in the wrong century. Grand would have fit back in to Japan, Tokyo, the Middle East, because he was true Nahate. He was true Nahate boy. He was true to the art. He lived it. He taught it. He teached it. He preached it to us. He had his times out in the snow, running up the hills, running in the rain. Great Grandmaster Wilson had us in the rain. Great Grandmaster Wilson had us in the backyard training in the rain. Freezing cold. We'd be cold, but he'd be teaching us. Grand taught martial arts. I never thought the day would come when I would be standing here and not see him. And I owe a lot to these great brothers of martial arts. And I'm honored to have stories where he used to turn the lights out on us at Brick Towers. He came one night and turned the lights out, and we was all in the dojo up in the corner, scared to move because we didn't know what was gonna happen. I remember one day at public service, Grand had his 10-speed bike. And he was gonna demonstrate techniques on the bike. And I tried to walk and hide behind the people. He called me up and demonstrated techniques with a 10-speed bike. I never seen anybody do that. I have years with Grand, and I have years with Grandmaster Floyd. And we have 45 years together in the martial arts life. And I like to thank my bishop for being there to teach me spiritually. And his great father once told me, if you wanted to know martial arts, open the Bible. So I went and I opened the Bible and I found some of the greatest warriors of martial arts in the Bible. And it's the greatest thing you can ever want to learn. And spiritually, I'm happy that I can say I was a student of Grandmaster Godfrey, Grandmaster Bill Wilson, also Grandmaster Eugene David Floyd. And in 1986, Grandmaster gave me my last promotion at the Boys Club on Avon Avenue. And it was the greatest thing that could ever happen. And I thank all these brothers of martial arts, all my true friends, all those I admire. I can't say nothing about this man because when we was growing up, the 512 was the school. You had the 512 on Springfield Avenue. You had James Fane on Bergen Street. You had the Turtle System, Ninja Turtle on South Orange Avenue. You had 8th Street Gym. You had so many brothers out in the audience. Ain't naming no names. In high school, we used to be in the bathroom at lunchtime sparring in the bathroom. We be in the bathroom, right? We didn't eat lunch. We locked the door. Is that right, Seth? We locked the door in the bathroom, and sponge. It didn't matter. That's where you knew you had it. When you ain't had no past. And Granny didn't believe in past. But thank you. Thank you, Grandmaster Fredrick. Thank you, Grandmaster. Thank you, Grandmaster Peanut. Thank you, Grandmaster Reginald Good. All my friends I grew up with, we knocked heads in the bathroom, locked the doors. We had a great time growing up in this art. And we all owe that to Grandmaster Fredrick Brian Godfrey.
Ladies and gentlemen, Grandmaster Ruben Santiago.
I'd like to thank everybody for coming. Those of you who don't may not know who I am, I happen to be one of Fred's oldest way back when. I started with him in 1969. I met him off of Springfield Avenue on a Saturday afternoon when my band was performing for a street festival around the corner from my last school. And he came out to put out a demonstration, and he liked what you were doing, and I liked what he was doing. So we talked, and he said, well, you know, get together, we'll train. So I wound up training with Barry Barlow, who happened to be one of the groundbreakers. And he came down one day to check out the class, and I said, you get a guy for the street festival? He said, yeah, you got to play the school thing, yeah. And we struck up a friendship over music and martial arts. He was a big Elvis Presley fan. I was. He loved all the big band sounds and that whole scene. I particularly wanted to say, I spoke to him that Sunday week that he passed. He said he was tired and he wasn't feeling right. And he just, I was trying to pump him up. I said, you know, we're going to give up. Keep fighting. Just keep it faith, it'll work out. He said, I don't know. I said, well, I'll call you again, we'll talk some more. Wednesday morning, I was on my way to work about 5 o'clock in the morning. Got on the train, nodded out, where I went by the church. I heard him say to me, hey, I'm going. I just came by to say goodbye. I opened my eyes and I said, did I just dream that? Did I really hear him say that to me? That was just my dream or imagination. Went to work, sometime during the course of the day, captain called me to tell me they were back. And I said, wow, he kept his promise. He told me he would say goodbye to his brother. And he did. And I believe it. So what I want to say is to him, that I didn't get a chance to, I want to thank him from the bottom of my heart for everything that he's given me, for everything that I've become as a martial artist, for the things that come to me through martial art, even jobs. And I'm going to miss him. He's my best friend. We did everything together. Just things I could tell each other. You don't have the time. So, I call to Fred all the time, so, Fred. Thank you from the bottom of my heart, for all my love. Thank you so much for what you've done tonight. And for all of you, all you people sitting up there, thank you. Grandmaster Bowles, Grandmaster Wilson, I want you to know one thing. Everything that I know in the martial arts, well, see, given to me by no Puerto Rican guy, white guy, Jewish guy, anyway. It was a black man who gave me what I had. Grandmaster Bowles made me a terrorist. Grandmaster Wilson made me Goshishan. Fred made me a ninja. Thank you very much.
Representing Grandmaster Breaker, Miss Floyd would like all the original Ninja Turtles to please stand up